Please follow along with us in hashtag Genoa for all our pics and videos in Discord. You can find the links in the show notes.
You know, I don't want to play Frogger.
I'll get it this time. Look, self-made entrepreneur, no manure, I'm number one. Goose down, jacket, maverick, top gun. Look, evil Knievel, I'm trying to stunt. Polo the horse.
Come on, Craig. Howdy, Craig. We have a new, and thank you so very much, person who is going to be doing some music for our show. So one of our buddies at work, his name is Lorenzo. He's from the St. Louis rap scene, and it's called the Almighty Music Group. And I said, hey, this sounds really good. Can I use some of this? And he's like, yeah, you should use it for your show. Oh, this song's like this?
This is so miscellaneous podcast. Broke a block of men, foot up on their neck. He need oxygen. You on thin ice on the rocks again. Daddy told me, well, son, don't drop your chin. Never 101, always hopping in. Tell him, set it up. Tell him, lock it in. Never count me out. Always count me in. Keep on losing count. Start that count to 10. Do not make a move.
I like this one.
Come in, foot up on their neck. He need oxygen. You on thin ice on the rocks again. Daddy told me, well, son, don't drop your chin. Never 101, always hopping in. Tell him, set it up. Tell him, lock it in.
We ain't going for none of that. On your block with that chop like a.
Here's this one's called Kill For. You can tell this is definitely from St. Louis.
Right.
But, no, dude, this is really cool. Is it storming over there yet?
Yeah, it's about to.
Is it going to be bad or is this going to be a normal
storm? I have no idea. I have no clue, man. What the hell did I do yesterday? I'm just trying to keep the dirt out. Any nigga that we.
But this is the one I really wanted to use for what we can do, maybe. This one I really like. This is just him by himself.
It's old, man. Shout out to DBG representative. You already know, man. Y'all, you ain't standing with us, then you standing underneath us. Yeah. And we all on 10, so you know, you feel that pressure. It's heavy.
It has a little bit of Jason in it, you know?
I want to thank you right now in case I don't see tomorrow. I'm still living in the moment, so if I die, I don't feel no sorrow. No sorrow, no sorrow, nigga. Hey, no sorrow. Look, I want to thank you right now in case I don't see tomorrow. I'm still
but
living.
There you go. That's the Almighty Music Group. I don't know how I'm going to do that, but I like a lot of them, so... Mm-hmm. Cool. I told him I want to try to use it, and he's like, that's cool, thank you. So, hi, everybody. Welcome back to the Miscellaneous Podcast.
Yeah, welcome.
This is the Kira and Polly Advent Edition. And we want
to
talk about,
hear this.
Yeah, so we're going to talk about our big trip to Indiana. We are live here in the Miscellaneous Podcast studio headquarters, where we have the double mics going. Here, I'm going to see if we can turn on just like the local camera without... out everything messing up, so you see what we're looking at.
Okay.
Well, we're slowly getting it together. So
yeah.
It's
all right. So you see us right here? Hi.
Yeah, I'm trying to make you big.
Make it big. Well, even with this as the camera, this ain't that bad either.
No.
We can fix this back here.
Yeah.
No.
But now we have two. Do we have an echo or anything? I think we should be good.
I don't think so.
Oh, it.
Not until I break something. You two look like the sweaty balls ladies.
Oh, you mean like the NPR SNL people?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yes, yep. I like the way your balls smell.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. We have this. This came from my stepdad's girlfriend, the Polly's Big Book, Polly's Book of Big Adventures ideas, whatever.
Uh-huh.
So, yeah, so we did a little outline for us. There you are over there, buddy. I see you. You look good.
Mm-hmm.
Microphone in your face.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, if I do too much moving, man, this fucker's going to stop working.
Yeah, mm-hmm. You don't like that.
So, you guys went to Indianapolis.
So this all started.
How was the drive?
Well, let's begin with this. It all started on a fateful day at work, of all places, where she comes around the corner and goes, "Babe, how much do you love me?"
Red alert! Red alert! Red alert!
Mm-hmm.
Uh huh. Yeah, it's like when you hear those in
it's
any
like,
relationship. Yeah, because there are two things. One, some shitty invite you got to do with a bunch of people you don't care about, or two, money. Well, I guess money's for either one of them, but yeah. So then she told me what it was, and I was kind of like, all right, let's see what we can do. And it took a couple days because I'm not used to it. I've never done that. I'm not big into that shit at all. So
into what shit?
Into Comic Cons or anything like that. This was a con.
Oh.
What kind of con was it?
You aren't?
No.
Oh, I thought you were.
No.
This was an Indiana Comic Con.
No. Was it particular, like, is it DC Comics? Is it something like that? What was it?
It was more like just hodgepodge of everything.
Cool.
From The Flash. We had Grant Gustin.
Oh, that's my butt. Oh, got me in the butt. Oh.
And Carlos and...
Stop! Don't do that!
Vandalia's. I always butcher his last name.
I'll always remember this.
We had voice actors from anime there. We had voice actors from Star Wars, Clone Wars.
Hello there.
We had
Adam Savage.
I'm so pumped!
It was from Mythbusters. We had Paul Williams there. And we had John Glover there. We had the actresses from Charms there.
Yeah, all of them except for Alyssa Milano.
And then we had actors from Sons of Anarchy there.
Yeah. So the main guy from Sons of Anarchy and Ron Perlman were there. And like, I almost wanted to get that dude's ticket, but it was like $200 and some odd just to get a photo op with him. And his line was insane. Okay, we're jumping the gun here. Let's go back to. So while we're sitting there and she's talking about it to me and she's like, this is this and this is that. Paul Williams came up. And I was like, you're fucking with me. Let me see that. So Paul Williams, to me, is very influential with my life because I grew up watching, listening. We are big Carpenter fans in our household. He wrote 90% of the music for the Carpenters. He was in Smokey and the Bandit. He was in a lot of the Muppet stuff. He wrote The Rainbow Connection.
Why are there so many songs about rainbows and what's on the other side? Rainbows are visions, but only illusions. Rainbows have nothing to hide.
And he was also the voice actor for the penguins in Batman.
Yeah, that's what we found out later. I didn't know that because you said this is why he's here. So I was like, oh, Mazuba Guabo. And
so
then
that's who you were going to see first?
No. Ron Perlman was who I saw first. But Ron Perlman was the second I saw. Hold on 1 second. I got to fix my microphone. It wasn't at the right height.
That's what she said.
Oh, damn. And shots fired. And then I'm going to say this to you.
Oh, my God. Who the hell cares?
And I was like, I got to see this guy before he dies because he's like 80,000 years.
And he's like, I need a PowerPoint. You know, you got to convince me. Like, why should I do this? So I tell him, he's like, it's going to be expensive. I'm like, I'll make you a deal. I will pay for all your photo ops and I'll pay for all my photographs that I could pre ahead of time. You take care of the gas and the hotel and the food and we'll call it even at that.
Yeah, I made out like a fucking bandit. So she books everything and then we go out on our quest, so to speak. But everybody at work had to find out about this, like you do, right? And we have this one guy, Carlos, who you're going to meet later on, the audience and Aaron. Great guy, whatever. But so he goes, okay, and I'm butchering, I shouldn't be doing this, but it's funny because he goes, okay, you guys are going to go to Indiana. I want a Starbucks cup. I want one for the state of Indiana and for the Indianapolis. They're specialized mugs that you can buy at Starbucks.
Only in particular spots in states and cities that you can get.
So there you go.
Like collector's items.
Yep.
Yeah.
I didn't know that until Carlos told me.
Yeah, he was really happy when I, because you missed the next day at work. I went in there and I just dropped it on his desk and just kept going, like didn't think anything of it. And you hear him like, party! That was great. Thank you so much! Yeah, I'm just, don't mind me. I'm not racist.
What?
He's Latino. And
awesome.
I don't think anyone thought that.
No, well,
I hope not. Anyone was thinking that.
But
oh, he's an awesome guy. He's, oh my gosh. Okay, keep in mind, I had a schedule for us. I'm thinking, when I go to these cons, I always have a schedule. And we decided we were only going to go one day. Okay, I'm thinking, okay, the night before we're going to pack.
Okay, it starts at like 10:30. We have that's when the doors open. We have to leave at like 4 o'clock in the morning because it takes like 3 to 4 hours to get there. And we gotta, you know, make sure we get our hotel and get on the waiting list for, you know, do whatever we have to get our room and everything and get ready.
First sign of distress. We call the Marriott the night before to make sure that we were all ready to go with our booking and everything. And they're like, yeah, your room won't be ready till 4 p.m. Like, what the hell is that? Usually,
yeah, I'm check-in is usually 4 p.m.
I always thought it was like 11, 12, 2. And then I was like, okay, no, can you? No. And then I was like, can I just buy the room and just be ready to go? No. Okay.
Yeah, you got to pay for the previous night. Yeah, check-in's usually 3 or 4 at a hotel.
I did not know this because, well, we're going to jump ahead, but we'll get to the next one. Okay, so.
But, like, to me, that was kind of fine because I'm thinking, okay, we'll be at the con most of the day anyways. You know, that wasn't going to be a big deal.
Yeah, they can just hold your luggage.
Yeah.
Just get your keys and come back.
I don't know because, like, every place I've ever been to, when we get to there, we go straight in there. We check in. We get our stuff. We go up there. I've never had an issue like this before because I wanted to drop all our shit off in our hotel room. That's what I wanted to do, but we couldn't. So, not only that, we wake up the same time we wake up at another job. And so, the point I was trying to make is I used to be an anytime ready to go type of guy until I started this new job and living with you. So now it's like when 4 o'clock in the morning hits, I'm like, no. And we went drinking the night before, or that didn't help out either.
No, that makes it a little difficult to get the fuck out of bed.
Yeah. Pickle shots. Have you ever had a pickle shot before?
No.
Oh,
no.
God.
I've heard of
so
them, but
gross.
It doesn't sound the most. I'm sure it's good.
It's, oh, so
I don't mind them. They're pretty good.
Did you guys have friends go with you?
No.
No.
No, oh, we just, okay. This is our little thing we wanted to do. And so we head out in the morning and I'm exhausted and I'm driving. And that was thunder, by the way. And I didn't know it picked up on the mic.
Yeah, here too.
Okay, so is it raining there yet?
Yep.
Okay, is it coming down in sheets of rain or is it just like generic?
Just regular old rain.
And the thunder rolls.
Because we're looking at it out the window, which is directly in front of us. And it's pretty cool looking. Okay, so we're heading out, and I'm tired, and I'm like, what time does this con start? And she's like, 10.
Is that a new time zone, isn't it?
Yeah.
That too. I didn't know that either. So
yeah, I think it changes in India.
Yeah, it goes up an hour, and I took that into account.
I didn't, because I don't know any better. I was like, we could have slept there another hour. This is bullshit.
What a big fucking baby.
Oh, yeah, it was, right, dude.
Okay, so then what happened?
I was asking Jamie about, like, so me and Jamie have a lot of communication issues we're working on. Mm-hmm. And then I found out a lot about myself in a short period of time when I was like, how come you never answer me when I ask you a question? And she goes, because you'll ask me more questions.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I wrote that down, too. That was a remembering right there. When I answer you, you answer me more questions.
Yeah, and if it's not the question he wants to hear, he gets mad.
All right.
So, there you go. So the drive for me kind of sucked. And the reason why is because I went from my old job of up and about, always running around, lifting heavy stuff, to a sit down at a desk job. And, you know, I need to start like working out when I get home or something.
Oh, are you at a desk all day?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, no. I didn't know that's what you were doing. Oh, man.
Yeah.
I went feel from, the pain, bro.
Thank you. Yeah. So the good thing that came out of this was Jamie likes to make frequent stops as much as I do. Mm-hmm. And that's yeah. I love that. So she's like, can we stop over here? Because I want to pee and I'm going to stretch my legs. And I'm like, oh, thank you. So that worked out really well.
Mm-hmm.
One of our stoppings, we watched a guy almost hit an entire family backing out.
Would you like to know more?
We were like, oh my God.
It was cool. So this one guest, so it was right before we hit Indianapolis. Most of the trip was kind of whatever. We brought snacks. We're not going to do that next time. I like just stopping off somewhere and just picking up something and then leaving. Mm-hmm. Because that, not only that, it took up a lot of space for your swords. Which we'll get to next.
Oh, my God. You were driving there with swords?
No.
Oh,
way
this
back.
Is the way back. Okay.
This is the way.
This is the way.
This is the way.
this is the way.
Like, damn, we guys getting doing some LARPing on the way there.
Total concentration, water breathing, first form. Water surface slash.
It's all hitting shit on the dashboard. Well, when we hit Indiana, the gas went down like a dollar almost. Mm-hmm. It was really nice.
Yeah. Yeah, so. Their taxes are different there.
Mm-hmm. Just talk. You're good.
No. You were doing good.
Oh, thanks. But no, it was really cool. And then, so I was like, let's stop one more time before we get to Indianapolis because the city might be different. So we pull in and everybody is at this gas station.
We were like, we think we made a mistake.
I'm like, maybe we should just kept going. So we're circling the station, gas station pumps, right? You're circling.
Everybody was. That's the thing.
Yeah, it was like something out of a weird fucking movie, man. It was like a Denny's mixed with a Subway mixed mm-hmm. with a gas station or some mm-hmm. shit. So they get this family that looks like they're in their church Sunday's best are coming out. And we went, did we go on Sunday or Saturday? We were there Saturday. Yeah. So they're all dressed and they're coming out. And this guy who looks like a delivery driver is backing up fast to get into this one spare, like this guy was mm-hmm. leaving. So he's trying to get in there, dude. And he literally
almost hit them.
He was like maybe inches away and the mom's yelling and he turns to look back, eyes glassy red like a motherfucker. No. Yeah, dude. And he's just looking back all
like drunk,
high, whatever, dude. And I was like, man. So we're looking at him from his driver's side, you know, because we're waiting to circle back around.
My jaw just like dropped. Like, how can you not? There's like mirrors on your side for a reason.
Yeah. And he probably has a backup cam too. And like the special needs kid that his mom's dragging out was all like, hey, drag what the it hell? Out.
Yeah, special needs kid that they drag around.
I kid you not. And then he stopped and he's like rolling on the window, like, hey,
the special needs of the driver.
The driver.
The driver was the one complaining. And it's like, dude, they have the right of way.
Yeah, no, well, that you hit a pedestrian. That's it. Yeah. You lose, you know?
Yeah. There's no one in that.
Yeah.
Well, those people, you know, they drive around those pumps because they sometimes you see them pull in and they're on the wrong side, like they're. Their mm-hmm. gas tanks mm-hmm. on the other side, and they drive around to the opposite side, that, still on the wrong side.
I do that.
It's like all you did was do a circle. You need to turn your car around.
I do that in Jamie's because Jamie's is on the passenger side.
Yeah. I've done it a couple times because you know I drove Hondas and you know Japanese cars for mm-hmm. a long time, and then I got Volkswagen, and then they're on the opposite side. I still do it. I've had this car for 2 years. I still pull up on the wrong fucking side.
There you go.
And it's diesel, so I got to make sure I don't put gas.
Oh, yeah, that sucks.
You know, yeah, Volkswagen, they did good on that. They, you know, the diesel cars, my car gets like 45 miles of the gallon.
Oh, yeah, you do have the Volkswagen, yeah.
Yeah, the Passat.
Yeah, I like anyway. It with your little Mason thing in the back and everything.
No, that car got smashed.
Oh, so there's a new one now. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Because that was one I did like, because that was when we first like were hanging out and stuff. I was like, dude, you're a Mason? That's cool.
Yeah. But, now I got a little alien badge on it. Looks
there
like.
There you go.
Yeah. So looks like. Nice.
Here's the picture.
Yeah.
Oh, alien badge. Wow. Cool. Let me enlarge you here.
Yeah. I got more if you want one.
Oh, dude. Hell yeah. I want one of those. Did you make that?
No, I got them off Amazon. No, it's a metal alien head with blue eyes. You see?
Can I glue a magnet on the back of that?
That
looks good on the refrigerator.
There's a you can. There's a 3M sticky back that you put on it, and then that's when I attached it to my car. Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah, so I've got to...
Look at him. He looks so prestigious with his beard now, doesn't he?
Yeah, so I got...
That's cool. I like that.
Prestigious, yeah.
Oh, yeah, dude. You look totally different with a beard, man.
Yeah, I know. That's I saw cool. My mom saw it for the first time yesterday. She came in town from North Carolina. And
yeah.
Yeah. She's like, your beard looks so good. Now you can work part time as a Santa Claus. I was like, Mom.
Oh, damn.
Oh. I'm only 190 pounds. I don't think I can pull off like a Santa Claus.
You had to really wear the suit.
Right.
Big old belly.
Stuff a pillow in there.
Oh, this is cool. As I'm looking out the window, the wind's blowing and it's getting closer. But I don't, every storm now, ever since I saw Tom Cruise's War of the Worlds, mm-hmm. I'm fucked.
That is so weird.
What?
The wind is blowing toward the storm.
Well, it's the 4th of July.
No.
Oh, see.
It's okay. You're fine.
He hit right behind our house.
Yeah, well, it's not gonna hit there again. Okay, because lightning doesn't strike twice in the same
shit.
Yeah, is that what you think about?
Yeah,
you know
the
what
storm,
I saw?
Yeah.
You know what I saw on, I don't know if it was on TikTok or Instagram Reels, but a tornado on top of the fucking mountain.
I saw that. Oh, that was
crazy?
Cool. Yeah.
That was nuts. I don't think that's supposed to happen.
No. No.
Harp. They're playing with shit in the sky. They're playing with the harp. I guarantee it.
Oh, yeah.
The weather control device.
Wrong button.
For anyone who doesn't know, HAARP, H-A-A-R-P, is a weather control device in Alaska.
Yeah.
For anyone who doesn't know.
And fun fact, that all began back in the 40s in World War II because they thought it could utilize as a weapon. They even tried using the Paris Tower for that, too. I forgot.
Yeah, weaponizing the weather. Mm-hmm. And yeah, what they do is they ionize the atmosphere, and you can do all sorts of crazy shit with that.
But yeah, they do that in Alaska, Antarctica, all the good jazz.
Mm-hmm. China has one too, I believe. I think Russia has one. There's a couple of harps that they got around the world.
What do you think about that? Trump finally getting, well, not finally. Like, I don't know how to look at it, man.
Well,
he's guilty. Sexual deviancy.
Well, no. He's not guilty of rape. He is financially responsible for her abuse that she faced or whatever.
But that was also a criminal hearing, though. So a criminal trial.
No, it was only civil.
That was a civil one?
Yep. They found him financially responsible, not criminally. Because he's past the point. He's past
the statute
of limitations.
Well, I thought they were saying like there wasn't one for rape anymore.
I don't know, man, dude. They're throwing whatever they can at him. They just just trying to
Joe's conspiracy about this is pretty not what I thought it'd be. He goes, the reason why he keeps getting in the news, and even though it's negative, because they want Trump and Biden on the next ticket. That's why.
Well,
and I'm like, I don't get it, but it's kind of different, you know.
Yeah, I have some other concerns, though, especially since Elon Musk, picked the new CEO of Twitter, and she's a chairperson on the World Economic Forum. I have a problem with that.
Oh,
I have a big problem with that. Klaus Schwab, all those guys. Yeah.
Yeah.
I've got a problem with that.
Yeah, because that's the countries that are like against America or something, right?
Well, no, they're part of the World Economic Forum, which is part of the New World Order. You know,
yeah, that's what I meant by that. Yeah.
Yeah, they're under they're with the UN and all that stuff. Why?
Oh, wait, no, never mind.
One?
I think mine's a little different than I don't know. It's Elon Musk. He also believes that humans are bad for the environment and stuff, too.
Yeah, well,
which they are, but you know. Okay, yeah. Jamie's giving me the look, so we got to continue.
Yeah,
on.
We got to roll.
It's our adventure.
I like my bitches like my Zinfandel. Put your hands on me, baby, like you're reading Braille. Flip a coin where you want it, baby. Hesitate.
Never count me out, always count me in. Keep on losing count, start that count to 10. Do not make a move, bro, go block him in. Foot up on they neck, he need oxygen. Never count me out, always count me in. Keep on losing count, start that count to 10. Do not make a move, bro, go block him in. Foot up
we
on
get to
neck.
There and we actually pull up to the thing because I said, we still got to go in and tell them that we're here and we had to get all our stuff. And because I said it's on the phone.
This is where the second,
red flag comes in.
Yeah. Keep in mind, there was something else going on as we were coming into town that we ended up to find out that there was a marathon that was going on.
Yes. It was cool. Okay. I've never seen a marathon before. Like in real life. In real life. No.
Oh,
so it was cool. We had to get over to the right hand side and we're like on the far fourth left. And I was like,
Huh. And you had to wait for all those people?
Oh, man. I was just like forcing my way through. Just hold on. Were you? Yeah. I was like, just turn my blinker me. On. Yeah.
Okay. Keep in mind.
Let's talk about your warranty.
Yeah. Indianapolis is very pedestrian friendly, but it's not driver friendly if you're from out of town.
No. No. I found that out. And that's later in the story.
Okay.
Oh, okay. I didn't know you were doing. So she just kind of stopped and looked at me. So then we finally get through, and I was like, where's that? It's right around the corner. Because, I mean, it was flooded, wall-to-wall cars, people, etc. And finally, I was like, okay, cool. We can finally get there. We pull in, and we don't see a parking. No. We went around first, or did we hold still. There you go. So we went, did we go straight up to the thing?
So we pulled in and we pulled around to ask the valley parking about where the garage is.
No, but we first went to the garage, didn't we? And we saw that it was blocked off?
No, we pulled in to ask for directions for valley parking.
Yeah. And the guy said, there was just a regular guy who said.
Yeah, that the
parking's closed.
The garage is full and there's only valley parking.
And then I went then around because I wanted to see it for myself. And they had a sign right there saying on a cone saying full. Yeah.
They didn't even ask if we were hotel guests or anything.
Yeah.
Oh, they didn't have parking for hotel guests?
No. Hold on.
Just wait. So then we circled back around and a valet comes running out. Now, to do the valet, it was going to cost us $57 just to park it.
Fuck.
And Jamie at first was like, I'll pay for it. I was like, okay. What I'm like, it's not like I'm broke or nothing, but she was just like trying to like keep the peace because she could tell I was starting to get pissed.
Yeah.
So then the valet guy comes out. I open the door and I said, bazooba guabo. And he goes, and that the valet asked us, are you going to be here? And we're like, yeah. Then he said, still go in the parking lot.
Yeah.
Parking garage. He said, we put that sign out for the marathon people so they don't just park in our parking lot. I'm like,
so go in there anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah. Gotcha. So we go in there and then we get a pretty close parking spot, like really close. Mm-hmm. So that was a green.
What if somebody paid $50?
That was a green flag.
Yeah.
Ding. But then we had to go straight to the convention. Because we couldn't go in the hotel to do our stuff.
So we had to go up to the W. So we took the elevator to the desk.
Yeah, so we can give them our name.
So
and
Pat,
give our
thankfully,
phone numbers.
Pat took care of us.
He was kind of walking us through everything. And we said, you guys don't have a pool or anything, but do you guys have the breakfast in the morning? No.
So they didn't have a pool. They didn't have breakfast.
Keep in mind, this is almost $300 for one night, and it's supposed to be two queen-size bed, and they were not queen-size.
I'm a land farmer, motherfucker!
The convention's literally across the street. Green flag. The convenience factor...
Oh, okay, that's cool.
Four-lane highway.
Oh, so you gotta go over a bridge?
No. It's the streets of Indianapolis, like four lanes one way, four lanes another. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So this one was just a one way to whatever. And so we're walking down and I'm like, sweet, there's some doors. I'm going to walk right across. And Jamie just starts bolting for the crosswalk.
I am not playing. I was not going to play Frogger on a four lane. Are you freaking kidding me? It was busy traffic.
Okay, for that, I'll give you this. Now the reason why I give a yay, because as she's walking I'm like, dork, I'm gonna cross the street, I got this shit.
Yeah,
well, I start
cool.
seeing Star Trek chicks coming out of the from our same hotel. Uh-huh. And I was like, okay, all right, cool. And they all start heading to the crosswalk. Groups of people started heading to the crosswalk, and I'm like, everybody here's a fucking square goody two shoes. Fine, I'll go. I mean, literally, that's how I kind of felt. So I get over there, now we're clicking the button to do the crosswalk.
And then I was wearing my Reverse Flash shirt, so people were, we were complimenting everybody on each other's shirt and all our gear.
This chick comes up and, like, pulls down her shirt, like, almost to see everything. Look at my Reverse Flash tattoo!
No, it was a flash.
Oh, it was a flash?
Yeah, it was a flash.
I should have took a picture of that, but... Oh, yeah, dude, she was just like, hold on a second, like, ripped her shirt down.
It was pretty cool.
Yeah, it was really cool, yeah. So I was like, and then standing behind her are the two Star Trek chicks. And I was like you guys in Star Trek. And it was kind of cool. And then we went across the street. And as we're crossing the street, we're seeing like people in night, like full knight's uniforms standing on the steps.
Knight's uniforms? You mean like armor?
Yes.
And then, knight's uniforms.
Yes. Like, yeah, it was badass. Okay. And then you see
suit
like
of armor.
Yeah, suit of armor. Thank you. And I was like, which one's that one from, Jamie? I don't know. And we're just walking into the upstairs into the convention up the little steps. Right when we walk in, it is literally like the number one best Halloween costume contest for everyone in the room.
It was full of lot. It's like the third most popular convention to go to in Indiana.
So what are really the cool other ones?
Biggest one, I mean.
Gen Con is the first one.
What's Gen Con?
It's another Comic-Con.
It's like for gamers and shit.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. What's the other one, like BlizzCon or something?
I don't know if BlizzCon is, but I want to go to a BlizzCon.
Yeah.
I'm Mr. T and I'm a Night Elf Mohawk. What's your game?
World of Warcraft.
Yeah, I heard Frazzly talking about it. They sounded pretty cool. Mm-hmm. Not if a bunch of Frazzlies are running around, but you know. That okay. Whole crew of people.
That whole crew of people.
But yeah. Like, I was still trying to get my bearings because I was trying to find, I had my pre-order tickets and I was trying to find the place to redeem them so we can get our passes to get mm-hmm. in.
Mm-hmm. So I'm looking around going like this. So in hashtag general, for all you listeners and Aaron out there, head on over to hashtag general. You can see the notes down in the show notes and you could follow along with us with our videos and little pictures.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
That's the Star Wars Trek guy. Remember him? Star Wars from Empire Strikes Back? Wars. He was flying with Lando Calrissian and the Millennium Falcon.
Yeah.
And he's like,
don't worry, my friend's down there. You'll have that shield down on time. Oh, this will be the shortest offensive of all time.
That guy speaks English, I'm sure.
So, like... Like eventually I asked people where do they get the passes at. So we had to go on the other side of the convention center to get it. But as we were doing it, Paulie was going, trying to take pictures. Like, dude, we don't have time to take pictures right now. You knew it on the way back. We gotta
randomly
get our passes.
Stopping people for her to take funny. Pictures with.
I'm thinking
that's funny.
It's like, dude, come on.
It was really cool. We saw a lot of cool costumes. And then it started hitting to ones that like, okay, that was Star Wars. That was the Flash with Jamie. Mm-hmm. And she's like reverse Flash, kind of funny. Mm-hmm. And then you start seeing these weird hodgepodges coming about.
Mr. Freeze.
And we think that's Dr. Xavier or just his dad. We don't know.
No, that's Mr. Freeze. That's Victor Freeze.
No, I know it's Mr. Freeze, but I will say this, though. Next year, I don't mind getting like a cooler, a motorized scooter or something, because standing in line is insane. Because
that's how you jump the lines.
Okay. So eventually, you know, we were getting the layout of the land. We went to find Celebrity Alley where we would get our autographs, where all the celebrities were. And then we went to... Well, simultaneously...
We're jumping the gun here. Let's talk about... We didn't know. Okay, we knew where to get our hoodie-kais, our little wristbands.
Yeah.
Then we're like walking back and we're like, she's like, it's not even open yet. I'm like, what do you mean? And we see this ridiculously long line.
Yeah, it was like turning and weaving.
Yeah, and I was like, what is this for? And they're like, it's a line. What? To get in. I was like, all right,
means
cool.
Get at the end.
So we're at the very end. We're with people with the T-shirts on, a couple people dressed or whatever. And we're just kind of bullshitting around. I'm like, this is my first one. Ah, ha, ha. And they're like, oh, yeah, this is What's-Her-Face's first one. And she was dressed as like Scarlet Witch or something like that. And then all of a sudden these doors open right next to us. And I look in and I'm like, what is that? And then like a couple people are just leaving the line to go there. And I'm like, fuck that. We're going. We're going in. I don't care where we're going. We're going in. I don't want to wait.
Okay.
So we did the right. We did the right one. We went in there and it's literally like a big vendor sale, like a garage sale.
It's
but like
big, huge shopping mall for geeks.
That's it. That would be the best way to say it. So
I see all the swords on.
Yeah.
The
so that was the joke because we're going by and I'm like, holy shit! I mean, we have the Halo guns. We have all different them. Yeah. We have the Keyblade Jamie has, and so
it's a big shield.
Yeah. So I was like, Jamie, look. you are home. So she went, and I took a picture of that. And then on the way around, we met other people.
Superhero garage sale. You're right.
Yeah. So we start seeing people dressed up in really cool different outfits, and we're taking pictures of them. We got that and this.
Well,
and
the fucker's got an accordion.
It's Weird Al Yankovic. He's dressed as Weird Al.
Oh, that's great.
And then we came across the guy who matches Jamie's Reverse Flash, the actual Reverse Flash guy dressed up as him.
Oh, there's this. I'm not familiar with all the superheroes now. There's Reverse Flash. What's.
Yeah.
Is he super slow?
No. It's a complicated story.
Okay.
So he's like, basically, he represents the opposite of everything Flash stands for. He's evil. He's, he is the negative speed force.
Oh, so his yin to his yang. So he should be really slow or normal.
Slow.
Dude, and Chewbacca.
Then, yes. Now, look, Chewbacca's rubbing my head.
Oh, God.
That's cute.
Well, that's cool.
Good times. Yeah. Oh, dude, I have a gazillion pictures. We're going to start posting some more. But
what's your shirt mean?
It's supposed to look like a NASA shirt, but it's the Daleks from Doctor Who.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So then we're meeting other people. So we had to go up a flight because this is a two-story convention. So as we're going
up. Is it in a casino or something?
No, this is just a convention center.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Who's that guy and girl?
That's Team Rocket. If you ever watch Pokemon, there's a group called the Team Rockets, and they're always like the ones against all the good kids or whatever.
Okay.
So we're doing that, and I was like, hey, Team Rocket, and we took a picture of them. They are so apt to take pictures with us. They do not care, because that's why they dress up,
Oh, for sure. Yeah, that's the fun part. God.
So, and here's one thing I was really kind of just, I was really just enamored by how well these people, make these costumes. Like, they're making costumes.
Mm-hmm.
If you look in the way back, that's a guy who made a Flash Lego outfit to wear.
I can kind of see it.
You can zoom in if you can, and it's in the back, and it's the Lego. He's like a 6-foot Lego.
Yeah, well, let me zoom in. Well, that's pretty cool, though.
Yeah.
So it's an Iron Man Lego?
No, the Flash.
Oh, the Flash.
Because the two main people who are there for the attraction were two of the Flash TV series characters.
Okay.
And their tickets were $110.
Well, Grant Gustin, his tickets were $110. Carlos's was $60.
Okay. So that's $60 for a photo and $60 for
an autograph.
An autograph.
And then you have Grant, who was $110 for both.
So just think of that. This crowd, you're not seeing a tenth of them. So that's like they made three different lines that filled up an entire room just to see Grant $110.
And Grant had five different sessions.
Yeah. Yeah. So there's two different things. So you have the photos and then you have the autographs. And the autographs, you have like a good couple minutes to kind of actually talk to them, right?
Right.
And interact and shake hands and got to get a little natural. Ow. Now this is a cool picture because these guys were just talking while they're waiting in line, but it looks like they're like facing off. Why is it not doing this? Is what this proton liquid, blah, blah, blah. Hold up 2 seconds. Takish,
it was 2 minutes 5 minutes ago.
Nice. This is great for radio. Here, talk amongst yourselves.
When we were doing it, I had a schedule because everything was like showed us the time of when their photo ops were.
Mm-hmm.
So I pretty much had a schedule pre-made and everything.
Oh, yeah, dude. So, yeah, we went up to this big board that showed like the date or the times when they'll be opening up for the photos. And then there all the stuff. It was good because she's like writing it all down because I'm looking at that going, wait a minute. Yeah. So that was pretty cool. Now, these guys were just talking to each other. But doesn't it look like they're facing off to fight?
It's that looks a little intense.
Yeah. I was like, what are you guys doing? And they're like, oh, we're friends.
Doesn't look like it.
Yeah. So here's another picture of a little more of the crowd with the Lego guy in the background.
And this was when we were in line for Grant's photo op.
Yeah. So these are like one, two, three. I think it was three or four lines just for Grant that go from one side of the room all the way to the other. So, I mean, it was, they were literally just like cattle herding them in, like, picture, go, picture, go. Yeah.
Ching, ching, ching.
Pretty
ching.
Much.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And that's when I saw people like Ron Perlman.
Oh,
and,
that's cool. He looks thrilled.
I know, right?
Oh, man, that's funny. So what was it like seeing him? I'd be starstruck.
It is. It really is. So you're in the line, and you're now up to these stanchions of black curtains around them, right? So you can kind of see a little bit in there. And then, like, through the seams, you can see all the way in. So I'm looking at it, and he's like, hey, what's going on, brother? And he's talking, and, you know, he sounds kind of like how he does in TV and everything like that, too, you know, the way his mannerisms are and everything. All right, brother, how are you? And he's all putting his hand around. They had, like, two girls come up, and he's like, hey, how you guys doing, you know? And
all that good stuff,
yeah. And and then
he was awesome in Sons of Anarchy.
Nice. Oh, hell yeah, dude. He was good. Remember, he had, like, keep doing his, like, the, what is it, the, didn't they have to do his, like, piercing and this cartilage or whatever, because he couldn't ride anymore or whatever. I'm sorry, I'm dragging on.
Oh, I don't know. You know, I didn't finish that series, but I think I was six seasons in, I think. I think it didn't end long after. I need to finish it, but that was such a good show.
Nice.
He's fucking awesome.
Hell yeah, rocks. Dude. So I walked, I was waiting my line patiently, and then he walks up, and he's like, I walk up to him, and he looks at me, and he goes, hey, come on now, or like something like that, and I was like, dude, I loved you ever since Beauty and the Beast from the 1980s.
Yeah, man.
Because I was for everyone out there who doesn't know, it was a TV show back in the 80s called Beauty and the Beast, and he played the Beast, and dude, it's weird because he just, oh, he was badass.
That makeup and everything fit him perfectly.
He
looks like a fucking monster.
Yes. So then when, like, Hellboy comes out, you're just like, yeah, I can see him doing this.
Oh,
so,
fuck yeah.
Dude, and he goes, he kind of looks at me all like, because I was trying to wow him. Like, I need to get his attention for that short period of time. So I do that, and he's just kind of like, he just kind of looks at me and, oh, thanks, brother. And then he goes, all right, let's take the picture. And I was like, cool. That's why I was like, yeah. Now, here's the one guy who was $110 a pop.
Great. Okay. So, like,
and he is who?
He is Grant Gustin. He plays Barry Allen on The Flash, on the CW show The Flash. So, when I finally got up, I was like, holy crap, it's actually Grant kind of thing. It was like, because, it's one of those things, if you would have told me, like, 2 months ago, I'd actually meet him, I would have said, you're full shit kind of thing. Mm-hmm. Part of my language. Because, like, it's kind of one of those things where you don't really think you're actually there in the moment with the person, you know, you realize you're actually meeting.
Fuck.
So you didn't know that you were going to meet him?
Like, I wouldn't have predicted that moment, because it's like the actual basis. This is actually happening kind of thing.
Mm-hmm. I see.
You know,
okay. Star Trek. Yeah, Star Trek mixed with, like, mesmerized, whatever those words are, yeah.
And, it was over real quick, and I just, you know, I was kind of like, I was like saying hi and thank you, sir, and like being very polite kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
But
Lie, you're trying to cop a feel on his ass. Look at that. You could tell. That's some really closeness. I tried copping Ron's ass.
No, I had my hands to myself. I'm not you.
No.
That's why his face looks like shit on mine.
Yeah, she's I was trying to get,
yeah, I was like, hey, what's going on?
No. See, I'm not like you guys. Mm. I'm more polite.
What do you mean? I didn't say shit. I'm just listening to like you guys.
What I also like that is, like, not only do you get meet the celebrities, but you also get to meet other people from different places, and that, you know, you bond over stuff that you like.
Yeah. My bros up while they walk around with their nose up. I can never say daddy froze up. We can shoot it out. What's the hold up? What I want. So this is Paul Williams.
Paul Williams.
Yeah, this is the guy I was talking about in the beginning. And look how he's the same height as I am. And I'm a short guy. I'm bending over a little bit just to go, yeah.
Oh, but, yeah, to kneel down, huh? How funny is that?
I know, right? Shut up. So he was in the same room as this guy named John Glover, who played in I'm going to download this. You keep talking.
Now, were these the biggest stars here?
No.
Oh, there were bigger ones.
Yeah, I think Grant, Carlos, the Sons of Anarchy, and the Charm Girls would probably be the biggest ones.
Okay.
Yep. So this guy, and you can see in the background, because like this is actually at his actual
John Glover. Yeah.
Well, he was in the room with Paul Williams when I was taking my picture, because these two were voice actors of the Batman cartoon series from like the late 90s, early 2000s.
That's what I grew up with.
Yeah. Oh,
I thought that's a Crispin Glover.
No, I know. That would have been cool. But no,
fuck
John
yeah,
Glover.
Dude. Love Crispin Glover.
Lou, give me a milk. Chocolate.
So John Glover's sitting in a chair, literally like 2 feet from me and Paul taking the picture. And I was just like, yeah, like, I love you, man. And all this other stuff. Yeah.
He looks homeless. He looks a little rough.
Yeah, he does. Yeah. And it's funny because that picture was at near the end of our time there, because we were going down the line trying to get as many autographs, and we saw him, and I got to get one. I at least got to talk to him. And so we went up and we're talking to him, and he just got up and came around, started giving her a big old bear hug. And he was like, are you ticklish? And he starts tickling her and shit.
I'm like really shy around like new people and all that stuff.
Yeah.
So because like Paulie knows, when I'm around people I don't really know, I'm shy and introverted.
You kind of hang behind me as if I'm a human shield.
Yep.
How do you solve this contraption, Nigma?
Easy. You just have to be a genius.
I like John Glover from a couple movies like Payback with Mel Gibson.
Any Polaroids or trophies?
No, not this time.
Other stuff he's been in, and of course, Smallville.
I see once again you managed to walk away from a major debacle unscathed.
I was only there at Summerholt, Lex, because I was concerned about you.
Man, he's been in a lot of stuff.
Yeah, yes. He's cool as hell, too.
He was in Scrooge?
He wasn't Scrooge. I forgot to tell you that. Yeah, he was the guy trying to get Bill Murray's job. He was that guy.
You know, it has been such an honor to work for the great Frank Cross. I'm going to dine out on this for months. You know what I'm saying?
And he's so nice.
Oh, yeah. He is so cool.
He's
yeah.
so nice.
He
was so cool.
The one that the lady with the busted nose like sat on his lap and kissed him under the mistletoe.
Yes, that guy.
That dude. Oh,
yeah.
That's hilarious.
Yeah. So that's really cool.
That's cool.
That's an example of like the people that we were meeting and why we were standing in lines for them.
Carlos!
Hey, man.
Tom?
Yeah?
Are we flying?
Feels like it.
Oh, man. My head's in the clouds.
Get your head out of the clouds.
Jamie talks about, and you can tell the audience about your feelings and what you went through and all this other stuff with your family and how these shows and the things that like keep us to get away from our reality.
My mom passed away back in 2017, and I was kind of left to deal with the grief on my own. And I mean, I kind of, everybody handles grief differently. So, like, I understood how much it took a toll on my stepdad. I mean, when you're married to someone for so long and you're in the house that reminds you of your wife that just recently passed away, I get it. But I mean, I was left to deal with it on my own. And Carlos, Tom Kavanoff, and Grant always made these funny videos behind the scenes, and they were always, you know, get on the internet. And it, when they say laughter is the best medicine, they aren't kidding, because they got me through the roughest times, and they are my heroes.
Everyone loses someone they care about. The real test of character is what you do once they're gone.
And these are like the reasons why people go to these damn cons too, because they talk about this. They're, you know, you ever seen Guardians of the... Yeah, you've seen Guardians of the Galaxy, right, Aaron?
Yeah, I've seen that.
The guy who has the mohawk with the little arrow that goes and he whistles. Yeah.
These boys of mine wanted to eat you. I stopped them.
He talks about, in candid detail, he loves going to these cons because a lot of people open up about their personal feelings and how they use these shows, movies, these, you know, things that they gave them outlets to life. So let's go to Mikey D right here. So this guy,
he's Mikey D.
I call him that, but it's not his name. He's from Staten Island, and he's a huge Flash fan, if you can't tell from his whole getup. And he has the New York accent. He's just, so you know me, I just hang out. I'll just talk with anybody, right? So I'm waiting in line in this long line, taking forever for us to take pictures with this Grant and this other guy named Carlos. And we're getting to know everybody around us. And we're getting, like, there's a lot of families. There's, you know, mom, dad, and they all love Flash, and they're all there for this. And all of them are had to pay for every single one of them to get a picture. Mm-hmm. And we go, I look over this right-hand side, and there's this one guy. I'm like, hey, how you doing? He goes, how you doing? And I was like, hey, are you from? From Staten Island. And I was like, no shit. I'm like, wait, do you like Peter, whatever his name is, the comedian from SNL with all the tats and stuff?
Pete Davidson.
He's like, Pete Davidson. Yeah, he's like an eye cat. And so the lady in front of him was like, say cars. And he's
so going dumb. On, right? People in New York hate that shit. Like, it's so funny. Because my dad was in New York for... Oh man, more than 5 years. But he was in Manhattan and Brooklyn, and yeah, they for real talk like that. It's a little much sometimes, a little aggressive.
Well, that's what he was saying. Yeah. So we're talking back and forth. We're getting to know everybody. People to the left of us, to the right of us. And then we hear this huge crash behind us, and we turn to look. This kid, he had one of those portable, collapsible sit-down things, you know, those little discs where you pull them out and you could sit on them, like little stools.
Yeah.
It broke on him. He leaned back and it broke in half. And he's getting up. He's all, I felt so, oh God. And we're like, hey, you cool, man? And like all of us are like, hey, you good, man? You good? I'm fine. And you can tell he's like anxiety, stressing. No. He's like tall, like you, a little bit bigger than you. He's real thin. And we're just kind of like, do you okay?
How you doing? Are you all right? Yeah. Are you okay? Just sit back. You all right?
I think so.
Are you sure? Because you just went through a wall.
Okay, just a little pride. And like everybody started laughing because I was trying to make a joke out of it. Because I mean, you could tell he was really like freaking out.
Yeah.
And then that's like, when I...
Oh, huh? It's embarrassing.
It is embarrassing, but you could tell, like, not to make fun of any of these people, but you could tell... This is the when we're in gym class, these are the people you made fun of.
Right.
So I get it. I know it sounds bad to say it like that.
Hey, man, that's what happened back in the day. It was bullies, all right? That's what it was.
It's just a different generation.
So get back to Staten Island here. We're all talking. And I look over to my left, and I'm talking to these other people, and they had some taking pictures of their outfits and everything. And I overhear Staten Island and Jamie talking about what they, like she just said, like dealing with, this was a show for our escape from reality. Like he had personal troubles, and he was talking about that with Jamie. Then the mother that was in front of Staten Island starts talking to you and him, and it was like a three-way, like, fucking therapy session.
Even though it's just a show, you still can learn a lot. And, like, it's weird to say that there's, one of the things that you really take away from it is letting go of the past. That's probably one of the major themes in the show that really carries throughout the seasons, is you have to let go of the past and keep moving forward.
So this is Carlos. He looks like Cabby to me, our buddy Cabby.
Who's Carlos?
He played Cisco Ramon, which is one of Barry Allen's friends. He played it for several seasons, but eventually he left the show. He was one of my favorite characters because he was very nerdy. He made several... He's like Polly, who makes movie references and pop culture references all the time. And I find it kind of funny because, you know, before getting with Polly, that's the kind of boyfriend I wanted.
Oh, great. I'm a Carlos.
No.
I don't match the way he looks.
No, his character did that.
It's going to be like the TikTok version where it's like, this is who I wanted. This is what I got.
No, his character did that all the time.
That light was perfect bait. What made you think of that?
I don't know. I think I saw it in a comic book somewhere.
It was funny because when I got to him, I was like, again, it was that starstruck moment that, oh my God, this is actually happening. Uh-huh. Because, like, besides, for the most part, I can say after now, I met most of the cast of The Flash.
And you groped none of them, did you?
Nope.
Damn.
It's Bad Flash. Why the face?
Nothing. I just love chicken wings so much.
No, because we don't have the money to make.
Grant, Tom, and Grant.
We can't make Tom and Grant if we don't have any money, okay?
Okay, so why don't
we? Yeah, we can't make it. Short. Stop saying Tom and Grant. Okay, we're making this video.
Film Tom and Grant.
Make it through the rest of this video for me, please, yeah, okay? Yeah. Just as a favor to a friend without saying Tom and Grant again. Don't say it again.
Did that one count?
Dream by night, wish by day, love begins this way.
Who's one person that you guys have met that you were starstruck by? Like,
all
really
of them.
Starstruck?
All of them.
Really?
Paul Williams, I didn't know how to talk to him. Like, when I walked up, I'm like, I'm dead. You're the man. You know, I looked at John Glover. I was like, I love you, man. I didn't know what to do.
So when we were talking to the guy from Staten Island, he actually has a Twitch stream, because eventually a Twitch channel.
Yeah, we were talking about the podcast and stuff like that. So we're going to give a shout out to... Oh, shit. Give me a second. Keep talking. All right, here it goes.
You know.
Repentful Gaming. Is that one right?
Yep.
And it's on Twitch or Twitch TV, Instagram, goth4ms_g. We'll put it all in the show notes.
Goth4ms_g.
Yeah, goth4ms. He's very religious too. Didn't know that. So,
goth for multiple sclerosis.
Is he religious? I don't know. Well, whatever. But check him out. He plays all the current games, and it's funny because he was on while we were driving somewhere, and we put it on, and I was like, "Tell him like this or this or this," and then he all of a sudden he goes, "Hey, it's Kira. How you doing?" And he was playing like the Star Wars new game that came out. What is that called again?
The Star Wars
Survivor or something.
Yeah.
Jedi Survivor. And she's like, I was like, okay, cool. And I'm driving. I kind of look down. Okay, cool. And then she's like, this is not on easy mode. And I look back and like swords are flying. Shit's all going. And he's all like, oh, this got different. I was like, what the fuck, dude? After we had the photograph sessions, it was really cool. And I come across the Loki president. I love everyone's little stuff they have. They take time and make these costumes. And I just love it. It's fucking awesome. Sorry, I'm trying to look them up at the same time, so I'm probably dead. So did you watch Charmed at all?
Nope.
You know of it, right?
Yep.
Yeah. So here's they have the spell book. Like someone had the spell book. And that's what it looks like. And I was like, oh, that's cool. That's the Charmed spellbook. And she goes, yeah. And I was like, can you open it up? And she's like, yeah, it actually is a spellbook, you know, for stupid or whatever. And that, yeah, there it is. Look at that. That's really cool looking.
Who's the redhead? Wasn't there a redhead in Charmed?
Yeah. So
Alyssa Milano. And what's the other one?
I don't know all the names of it, but the ones that were there was Shannon Doherty. The other one. I don't know her name. She was the one I really liked too. I don't know why I don't remember her name. And then the one that came in after Melissa Lana left, the red haired girl.
Mm.
And all three of those ones were there. And dude, Shannon Doherty, for having stage 4 cancer, looks fucking okay. Like, I think
I didn't
she's
know she had cancer.
Yeah, I didn't know that either. Like, so it was all over the news like a couple years ago that she was in stage 4 cancer and that she wasn't going to do anything major. She was just going to go through the normal like stuff, but not like anything. Like, she figured she was hurt and she's still kicking it. I mean, that's awesome. I saw him like when we were all standing there waiting for like autographs and stuff. I saw him like walking when their break was over with and they had to go back. So that was pretty cool. Let me see where I was at. So then we go back down to the first floor because we were in the second floor and we came. It was really cool. So they had other rooms up there where we were buying like
comic books
and stuff like that. they had a huge D&D like room for people to play, well, just different games. And I laugh because all these people, their outfits are so, they, what do you do when you have to sit down and play a board game with a big ass sword?
Maybe like leave that in the coat room. I don't know.
He's sitting there holding it, and I had to take a picture. I was like, "The fuck?" He's like, "Well, what do you do?" Yeah. Let's see. Ooh, that thunderstorm came close.
I'm looking to see if somebody was carrying around a lamp.
We met a lot of people in the same room. I met Jafar and yeah, look at that one. That was awesome. It's like, whoa, I gotta take a picture of that. Hold on, babe. Like, you're the biggest Prince Ali I've ever seen, dude. So then we go down to the first floor, and on the way down to the first floor, we're seeing all these people too. I don't know what the hell this one is. What is this one again, babe?
So that is Hawks from anime called My Hero Academia.
Okay, cool. See, she had to interpret a lot for me because I didn't know
how
to
stop. Are those wings?
Yeah, and they moved. That was cool. No.
That's then, Pyramid Head from Silent Hill.
Yeah.
Pyramid Head. That was very original.
Dude, this chick was hot, too. Like,
who's Pyramid Head?
It's some evil thing that kills people.
Yeah, it's one of the monsters in Silent Hill, but many have speculated that it represents certain things to certain characters and various in various different things in main characters in various Silent Hill games.
You know, when they connect the dots, like secret connections like between different worlds, like superhero worlds, like the fact that John Connor and Neo from The Matrix are the same person. Isn't that crazy?
Oh, I remember. Yeah, I heard about that. That's crazy, dude.
When I learned that, I was like, oh, fuck. I didn't know the same lady wrote both those books, both those series.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Go ahead.
So I was just like, how'd you, it was all homemade. She made all that from scratch.
Yeah, I know a couple of people who do that. Yeah. They do it with like styrofoam and stuff like that.
So I'm like, hey, what's going on? Huh? Yeah, it's good. The guy standing next to her was her dad. And I was like, okay, I just got creeper vibes all of a sudden.
Yeah.
Fuck, you're here with your dad. How the fuck old are you? And everyone's it's gonna
that
shut
is bizarre.
Up now.
Was she grown? Was she an adult?
Yeah, she was like, she looked adult.
Oh, yeah. That's weird.
All right, so the next picture, love you, babe. So the next picture is more of those people.
So I believe those characters are from a video game besides the Hawk. It's from a game called Genshin Impact.
Okay. Anybody watched Black Adam? This is the guy that Pierce Brosnan plays in Black Adam. What's his name? Dr. Fate, yeah. Now, I have a lot of opinions on Black Adam, and I'm not, and I, you know, I voice that shit because this should have been a whole new Avengers shit and whatever, but whatever, I'm done with that. Okay, moving onward. So we're coming downstairs. We finally get over there and we're coming across. And this is what I love about everybody there, too. They're very, everyone there is sociable. This is their domain. I was into their world. And so I'm like, what are you? And they're like, I am blah, 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 blah. And you're like, cool. So after we saw what's his name?
Dr. Fate.
Yeah. We're coming down the escalators and the guy walks in front of us. And on Netflix, they have Daredevil. Mm-hmm. And the first season is this guy who pretty much looks like the Princess Bride's guy with the black hat and the black thing over his face and everything.
Do you always begin conversations this way?
And I was like, hey, it's Daredevil season one. And he turns around to us and pulls his mask up and goes, I can't see shit in this. And then turns, puts it back on and just keeps going down the escalator.
All right.
Is that Sailor Moon?
Yeah, that's Sailor Saturn and Sailor Pluto.
Now, here's one thing I want to think. The person to the right-hand side is a guy, okay? Mm-hmm. And I noticed a lot of guys dressed as women's characters this time. Mm-hmm. Well, not this time, but like I saw. And that's a reflection of the 90s, because I was telling you that before. Mm-hmm. Like, in the 90s, a lot of guys wore women's sundresses and schoolgirl outfits for some reason. And so I'm not new to this. Mm-hmm. But what was new to it is that they're like, Mom, hold my purse. Huh. That's different.
And love, it seems, made flying dreams to bring you home to me.
Do you like music? Oh, yes, you do. We have a musical for you. From Nora Allen.
Michelle
Allen.
Harrison.
Harrison Allen.
Michelle Harrison.
Michelle Harrison. For you.
So now we get to the line. For Jamie's
autograph for Grant.
Mm-hmm.
And this is like the line is in sectioned off in what's called sessions. And we're in the fourth. Is that right?
Yeah, we were in the fourth.
Oh, my God. Dude, the line was like literally almost close to the damn doors.
Yeah, because this is where we met Josh.
Yeah, yeah. So she in front of us was this guy wearing a flash shirt and he's kind of, you know, whatever. So we're sitting there talking. And my feet are killing me. We're now stopped. And all I'm doing is looking around at everything. And
like a little kid.
They're talking about Flash shit.
We were just going on and on about geek stuff. We jumped from one subject to another. We were going back and forth. We were just jumping subjects. From
it looked like y'all were flirting, too. And I was just like, good. I'm going to go sit down. Fuck this. So I sat down with some other people at the side of the wall on the ground, like where you see this last picture, like that's what the wall looked like. We just sat down against the wall there and we were talking and your line slowly was moving and I'm taking pictures.
And then you lost me somehow.
Yeah, and then I was like, I took a picture of a crowd and I'm like, hey, you're somewhere in there. And they were just all added to each other, man. That didn't come out right. But they're just talking all about nerd shit. And eventually I get up and I go over and this is like an hour later. And I go over there and they're still talking. Like they were like Energizer bunnies going, oh my God, miss, oh my God, man. So finally we get up to the line. But before that, we met a Ghostbuster that looked too much like Dan Aykroyd's character with the cigarette in the mouth, dude. Remember that from the first list?
Yeah.
Oh, whatever. And then we met a sex bot. We saw a sex bot come down. That was
sex
cool.
Bot.
Yeah.
That's not a sex bot. That looks like a microwave with legs.
That was the joke.
Oh.
And then we have a what's this chick's name? What was she? She's from a video game, right?
Yeah, she's from Overwatch.
Yeah. So you have that. And then did I take a picture of the guy with you or not? I don't remember.
I don't think so.
Hmm. So we get up to the line where there's even more stanchions because it's like really close. Mm-hmm. And so Jamie's all like, okay, you can go now. And so I'm like,
No. I told him to wait here, wait for me. Because like I knew once we get up there, it wasn't going to take long. Mm-hmm. And I knew it wasn't.
Okay.
And like.
I thought you were like, you need a little alone time with old boy.
No, because like I told you to wait there because. Once we get closer, they're going to just shoot us.
You can't do that. Did you really say that? Because I didn't hear wait, because I wandered off.
Yeah, I know you wandered off. I told you, wait by the trash can. Once we get through here, they're just going to shoot us.
Oh, you did say wait by the trash can. Yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't want to know that. I'm going to wait by the fucking trash can.
Okay.
No, there's too much shiny objects everywhere. So, yeah, so I whatever. They go in there and they do their thing. And I'm like, hey, you're going to do
so,
your thing.
So, like.
But it was good that I did because I got a picture of that for you, which was Spy.
It was the Spy X family.
Yeah.
Oh, it's so cute.
Yeah, little baby and everything. See what wandering does?
I don't know who that is.
Did you guys go to the Carlos after that?
So, like, I went through the line. I finally got to Grant, and I was saying thank you. I told him thank you, and he's like, for what? And I explained to him, and, like, he was like, at all, like, in, like, kind of like shocked, and I was like, you know, I explained to him why thank you, and he's like, you're welcome, and I'm sorry, you know, for your loss, and you know, and I told him thank you for, I know it's your job for doing this, but thank you for everything you've done for us over these past years of being the Flash, because Flash is in its final season.
Oh, okay.
So, and like now he's got. You know, now he's got a wife and kid. And, you know, when you're an actor, you sacrifice your time away from your family to do your job.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's, you know, that's a lot to sacrifice.
Yeah, it is.
You know, and I thanked him for that.
Did you try to cup him? Ow, stop hitting me.
Right to the balls.
And then I jumped. That's when when we were done there, I was waiting for you. Because, like, I was waiting for Paulie because he had my wallet. And Paulie was nowhere to be found.
What did you need your wallet for?
Because I had to pay for the autograph for Carlos because I couldn't.
Oh, yeah, that was it. So she called me.
If he really cared, he would have done it for free. I'm just kidding.
And she's like, where are you? I was like, oh, I'm at the entrance. Find me there. You should put like a line.
I know. I'm going to need one of those harnesses for you with a leash so that you won't go far.
So I go back over there and the dude, and I was like, and Josh. I was saying, well, before Josh, sorry. And I was like, where's your dude at? You should flirt with him to get in line.
No.
And you're like, no, I'm not going to. I'm like, seriously, like, just be like, hey, baby. You mean? And I was like, you can do that with any of these guys here. Trust me. Watch Don't it. Kick me. Okay.
Yeah, look, I am only one person's girl, and that's yours.
Oh, thank you.
So, you know, no.
I'm going to exploit the shit out. No, I was kidding. So, I was trying to get you to do that for real. I was. I was like, flirt with him. Get up in line. No. Well, it's like a six-flag zigzag to get to Carlos. So, I'm like walking in with him. She's, you can't be in here with me. The rules say so. I'm holding your shit. You're fine. So, we're going through the line, and then there's the, what's his name again? Josh?
Yeah.
There's the Josh guy. And I was like, get up there. No!
No.
And then all of a sudden, he goes, hey, come up here. And he looks back at the girl behind him, and he goes, yeah, she's with me. And I was like, dude, go. And you're like, no.
And then I told you to go. And then that's when I said, go. Can you go hold his place in line?
You go away.
I asked,
so I can flirt with him.
No, so I asked him since he let me, you know, do that.
So did you jump the gun with him?
Yeah.
All right, so there you go.
So
you did go up there with him, yeah.
I went up there with him. That's when I texted you.
To go to some other place. I thought that was another one you guys were all going to go to together. So I went over to that other line. There was no direction for the line. It was just a big clump of people.
Mm-hmm.
And then the lady that was working there, I was like, where's the line? And we're like, I thought you would know the line. They started forming a line. By the time like it got organized, mm-hmm. people were all like, dude, we were here longer than you were. And I'm like, I'm just holding a spot. I'm like, I don't even know what we're doing here. I don't even know this person.
This ain't even my car. I'm way over here.
I'll just get in the back of the line.
Well, he's more than just a criminal now. Apparently, he's a meta who can travel through mirrors.
Oh, I got this one. He's
Mirror Master.
What the?
Boom.
That's good.
Thank you.
Says she has the ability to induce crippling vertigo.
She's a top. That's her name. Top. Amazing. What? You want to go?
So I finally got to Carlos, and he signed anything. I told him thank you, you know, and like, you know, I explained everything, you know.
Mm-hmm.
He like grabbed my hand.
Yeah, I heard about
that. And like, he's like, you know, thank you, because I know that was hard for you to even tell me that. Yeah. He was really down to earth.
Did you get all quivery when he grabbed your hand?
It was like, I was kind of, because like, I was kind of getting kind of worked up, you know, talking about it.
Oh, yeah. So he's really nice.
Yeah. And
so who do you like more, Carlos or Grant?
I think I like Carlos a little bit more.
Yeah, he's more friendlier, more. Yeah.
Well, and I had a little bit more time with Carlos.
Mm-hmm.
Because they were just shooting everyone through Grant's line.
Yeah, Grant. Yeah, line was insane.
When he left the show, when me and my friends were talking, like his character, you can tell the void his character left in the team.
Mm.
No matter how hard the writers tried to fill that gap,
mm-hmm.
you can just tell the void in it.
Yeah.
You know how it is when some characters leave the show.
You don't really like the show anymore unless you really like the main people. Yeah.
Yeah. And you can tell no matter who they tried to fill the gap with, it just mm-hmm. the chemistry and the balance of the team was not there.
No.
You know, he has a YouTube video of him singing. I'm thinking, I told him he really, he should try to really pursue the music career because I think he has the potential to really go all out in that.
Darling, open your eyes. Let me show you the light. Girl, you'll never find the love that's right. Darling, open your eyes.
Aaron, are you still with us?
Uh-oh. Yeah, I'm here.
Okay. they showed up, and then I was like, okay, cool. So I'm going to ditch you guys and go get my Paul Williams one because Paul Williams is ancient. No one knows who he really is, except for the fact that he was the voice of Penguin there. No offense. He has no line. I'm just going to go over there and get in line. Mm-hmm. And I had to wait like 10 minutes. So then we went shopping for a little bit. And that's where you see the guy from Halo. And above that is another Loki, because Jamie is a fan of Loki.
Surprise.
And I was like, get in there. Come on. Like, tickle her or something. You're the mischievous man. So he just kind of went, hur. But whatever. Good for nothing, bad in bed. Nobody likes you, you better off dead. Goodbye. In that line where those people are standing, mm-hmm. First off, who the fuck is Exit Man?
I don't know. I was looking at that. That guy's got a green exit sign on his shirt.
I love it. I took a picture of it because I was like, that is cool as shit. But I don't know who it goes to. And like the people in line with, because there was a few that were in line with the Paul Williams. They were like, was it Mystery Men?
And I'm That's what I was thinking, Mystery
Yeah,
Man.
And I was like, maybe, I don't know. But yeah, they were just, both of him and his friend were looking off in the distance. I was like, perfect picture, I guess. But that was the line for the last person that we saw, which to me was the coolest, no offense, because everyone can relate to, and we'll get to that. So I'm in the line with Paul Williams, and then I talk to him, and I tell him all the things like I told you in the beginning of this podcast about how much is, and then Jamie goes, oh, I know who he is because of his little pictures and everything. So I was like, yeah. The Smokey and the Bandit little guy.
Yeah.
He was in the Muppets and everything like that. So, and it was really cool. He actually signed two things for me. And I only paid for one.
What did he sign?
One was the one you saw earlier with us standing next to each other, right? Mm-hmm. And then this one was one he did when he was younger. It's called The Phantom of the Paradise or whatever. He actually wrote and directed this entire thing, but that's him young. And oh, he wrote, cool. Trust in Me, Snow. And that's one of the lines from the movie. And then the other one was the other one. But when I went to Paul Williams, I was bringing up, like, do you guys ever remember a movie called The Secret of Nim? It was a cartoon. It actually had Shannon Doherty as one of the
I've heard of it.
He sings the last song, like the ending credit songs. And he sang it for me, like right then and there. And
oh,
I was like,
cool.
And then I was like, dude, when you did that movie, The Phantom, whatever, that's in the picture there, there's a song called The Hell of It. And he goes, and he starts singing that. He's like, Roll on Thunder, Router. And I was like, oh my God, this is so cool. And I was like, dude, my whole family loves you, dude. Everyone's like, I remember this demos I found on YouTube with all your demos of Rainy Days and Mondays with the Carpenters and We've Only Just Begun and all that. You guys, you and the side. And he goes, yeah. And then I was like, what were the Partridge Family like? And he goes, I had a lot of fun with the Partridge Family. So cool.
That's funny.
Oh shit, hold on. I gotta call a button.
This is only a test. If this had been an actual emergency, the attention signal you've just heard would have been followed by official information, news, or instructions. This station serves the Northeast Illinois area. This concludes this test of the emergency broadcast system.
I don't know. Did you hear me coughing?
No.
Okay, good. It worked. We have a cough button. But so we get over there. And while I'm in line in the beginning, because there's somebody in front of me, actually, it was really weird for Paul Williams. John Glover was right next door. And I kept staring at him. And then to the right of me, do you remember that show Wings?
Yeah.
Remember the main guy who married the chick from the Wings?
No, you did tell me about this Wings person.
He was right next door to me, man. And I was like, hey, that's, what was this, Bill Naley or something
Tom
like that?
Tom Daly.
I've heard it both ways.
And I was like, oh my God, they look so weird when you see them up close.
I know,
and you could talk to them. Yeah, even though we weren't in line, I was like, hey, man. He's like, hey, what's up, Paul? And he didn't say Paul, but he's like, hey, what's up, man? And
yeah,
like,
right.
Oh my God. That would have been really cool if you knew my name.
You're like, what?
So then we swing it around to John Glover. John Glover didn't have a line because I think he just got back from break or something.
Yeah.
So we sneak in there and it was like $60 or something like that, or 80 or whatever.
Yeah.
And I just walk in. I was like, fuck that. I ain't waiting. I was like, dude, I loved you and this and this and this. And he's like, thanks. And he's talking to you.
And I was really starstruck. I was shy and nervous. He was awesome. Like, I known him from Batman. See, like, Batman, the animated series, was how I was introduced to the DC universe. It kind of really shaped who I am. Batman was my first superhero.
Oh, Batman, I hope you're watching, because I've got a very special surprise for you.
I don't know, Batman.
It seems too easy.
It's never easy with the Joker.
Really?
Yeah. The animated series is kind of my introduction to superheroes in general.
Who is the guy who passed away that voiced
Kevin Conroy.
Kevin Conroy.
So Mark Kevin Conroy, Mark Hamill.
Did you know that, Aaron? Luke Skywalker himself was the voice of the Joker from the animated series.
No, I didn't know that.
Yes. Now when you go back and look at those cartoons.
But I was going into Tosche Station to pick up some power converters.
They were pretty much introduced the whole DC universe to me in my childhood.
Mm.
So that's why it was kind of special to me, you know.
That's cool.
Which is kind of cool.
Now, there was a Harley Quinn, Aaron, that I did see there. And the only good, you know, there's a picture I have, it's only of her butt.
Mm-hmm.
And because I got close and I was like, well, take a selfie with me, Harley Quinn. She had meth mouth.
Oh no.
I think I got the butt picture still. I don't know. I know, such a disappointment.
Boner killer.
I haven't felt this out of place since that week I lived with Superman.
We must stop Lex Luthor before he irradiates the world's supply of gold.
Hi, sorry. I know you got a meeting going on, but, so we are officially running low on Mr. Pibb and Cheez-Its. So, you know, 800-mile drive for me, like, 5 seconds for you.
So who was your first superhero?
Superman, I think. That was it.
Superman?
Yeah, dude.
That's cool.
When I was a kid, we didn't
have everybody. Even
cable was just starting when I was a kid.
You know what mine was?
What?
Bishop from X-Men.
Really?
Yep.
I don't know who that is.
This is a challenge to you listeners out there. You're listening to this episode. If you like it, send it in the comments. I want to know who your first superhero was. We're going to get no comments.
It's okay.
But I think what was really awesome was our next celebrity.
That's the last one. Yep. Yep.
Coming up.
That was Adam Savage from Mythbusters.
This is so exciting. I'm going to have a grinectomy.
Did you get a picture of him? Where's Adam at?
No, we didn't get a picture of him.
Mm-hmm. Sorry. And then
we barely got his autograph.
Yeah. So while we're waiting, she's like, he does cosplay at these cons too.
Mm-hmm.
And the joke is they film him on YouTube and a lot of times no one knows it's him walking around.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's cool. I like shit like that.
Yeah, that's funny.
And they have a stanchion up, like a little rope line that says, you know, it's done. And I was like, because you know me, I'm like, fucking hop the fucking fence. Let's go, you know, fuck this. And I was like, I waved the lady over and she goes, come on, come on, come on. He's done. He wants to go back to his hotel room. Here, come on in real quick. So we go up there. We pay for like, what was it, $60 or something like that.
When I met him, I wanted to thank him because the things I've learned could potentially at some point save my life.
Mm-hmm.
Because like,
you talked about.
Yeah, because like, there's reasons why I keep the things I keep in my, you know, glove compartment in my car.
Your Bowie knife.
Keep your center point. Smash a window. No, really.
Yes. That's exactly it. Yes.
Keep your center point. Your center punch.
And I learned it from Mythbusters. Mm-hmm. I kid you not.
Yeah.
So that's why I wanted to thank him.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, you remember that episode, right? Where they kept submerging the car and Jamie's in there.
I did see that.
No, it was Adam in there and he kept rolling out the window.
Mm-hmm.
We tried busting open the door. Yeah, that was a really good one.
And
but
you can't
my first question.
You can't open the window or open the door until the entire car is filled with water.
It's full of water.
Otherwise,
yeah.
You're fighting a vacuum. So you have to fill the car first. Mm-hmm. Then you can open it.
That, and if you're stuck in the seatbelt, you have something to cut the seatbelt with.
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
Yep. Yeah. Is it that little black hook thing?
Is that the hook thing that's also the steel punch or something?
Yeah, and it should have like a knife and a saw on it. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
But yeah, you have your Bowie knife. You have everything. Literally, if somebody... Okay, so let's finish the story. So we're with Adam Savage and I walk up and I'm like, fuck it. The people in front of us are like, do you ever talk to Jamie and all that? He's like, yeah, I talk to him all the time because we still work together and stuff like that because they still do movie stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And then we get up there and like, bring back Mythbusters, bring back Mythbusters, bring back Mythbusters. He looks over at me, he smiles. He goes, they are not, our budget was so bloated and they ain't paying for us anymore.
Yeah.
And then he was talking about that. And then Jamie goes into her thing with the thing and. Yeah, it was really cool. And he actually sat and talked with us for like a good solid like 5 minutes or so.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no kidding.
Yep. As we're leaving, we look way over to past there and we see the black Power Ranger. Now, this is when the Power Rangers had the racist colors.
Uh-huh.
The black had the black. The Asian was yellow. You know.
I didn't have the bunny for the autograph because I wanted to spend
But
my
his
money.
Line was long, too.
Yeah.
And he's all Walter holding Jones. A little symbol up like, let's go, Morphin! And that's really cool.
But actually, I think he's going to be back in St. Louis soon.
Mm-hmm.
So if...
Just well, to see the Black Power Ranger?
I would.
Yeah. Now let's finish this, because this is where...
Finish the lyrics!
So... Well, we're standing next to Batman, a guy who has a full fucking Batman suit. And while she's getting her pictures all situated and stuff like that in her backpack, I was like, do you have any tools in that toolbox there or a tool belt there? And he pulls out his batarangs, dude. And I was like, oh my God. He goes, I made these. I'm like, these are fucking weapons, dude. And he's all like, I'm like, dude, do you ever want to throw it at somebody? Like, no. And then Jamie's like, that's what gets us kicked out. Like, that's what it takes? Okay.
Who has the coolest gadgets? Who has the tricked out ride? Who does the sickest backflips?
So now we're walking around and now we're going shopping. So she buys, how much was it? $600 worth of swords? $500?
Oh my God. How many swords can you get for $600?
Let's see. You want to take a... No, let's take it from my picture, so my phone, so I can send it.
I got pictures. I got two.
We will take but a moment.
Dude, there was a lot of cool vendors there for everything. And one of them, there was these Demon Slayer swords that she likes from the show. And while we're talking, I was like, where are you from, man? It was an Asian guy. Mm-hmm. Sorry. And he goes, Swansea. Swansea, Illinois? Dude, I'm from Fairview, man.
That's funny.
And he's like, oh, okay. And I'm like, you can't say Swansea without saying with an accent, Swansea. And he starts laughing, and him and his wife are just talking to us and shit. Oh, dude, it's funny as hell. We're like, where were you actually at? And he goes, oh, I was off 159. Dude, it was crazy.
That's
so
funny.
She buys what? Two or three ones from there or something?
So the one that cost the most was the... One was $300.
Jeez.
It was the Sound Hashira's weapon.
And that now that one's like a real, real one, isn't it? Or something?
I want a katana.
These are, dude, yeah, here, let me show you. These are the swords
like
she got.
For real, like.
Well, one of them is actually, isn't it like battle ready
or
some shit?
Yeah, one of them, yeah, Tanjiro's is battle ready.
Total concentration, water breathing, first form, water surface slash.
Yeah, like it actually fuck you up. Yeah, hold on, let me hear them posting it right now. And there we go, listeners. For all you out there, if you haven't died, go to the show notes, go to hashtag general, and you can see all the photographs and
$600
stuff.
Worth of knives, swords,
swords. Look at that. That is pretty pissed.
Yeah, that's
little
cool.
Little sheets and everything. Yeah.
You just do both of them.
No, why is there? Oh, there's more.
Yeah, there's two. I sent you two.
Okay. Oops, my bad.
Is that a pink katana blade?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
These are not the same ones?
No.
These are different ones?
Yeah, these are two different ones.
Oh, shit.
There's two sets.
That's what makes this $600 worth. Woohoo! There it is. So these are all in boxes, right?
Yeah.
So we're like duct taping them all up together and shit so we can walk out of the con with them. Mm. So I'm bear hugging this huge thing of boxes as we're walking all around. And I was like, oh, this is pretty cool. This is getting heavy. Mm. I'll carry it. Fine. Hands it to her. You could take them.
I would have carried them.
Yeah, you keep saying that, but like that was heavy as shit. So.
I don't care.
By the way, to throw that in there, about here's a green flag. They did get our room ready by noonish one. Mm-hmm. Now let's fast forward to now. So she buys all these swords. And I saw a Riddler cane I really, really wanted. But it was like $400. That he was like, or 200 or whatever. He goes, but it's handcrafted and it's brass. And all of a sudden, and I'm like, yeah, I don't give a shit about that, dude. I'm not paying that much for a cane that I'll hang out with one. Yeah, a cane, like a walking cane.
No.
Yeah. But I wanted one to match like the one from Batman Forever because I love Jim Carrey's version.
Enigma. Edward Enigma.
And how he spins it around and shit. I want that. I'm a big Riddler fan.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm too fat to really. I'd be like a fat Riddler. But so now we're leaving. And as we're leaving, it's kind of like you're actually having a dump of emotion. energy. Because now you're like, all right, we've just been walking for fucking all day long. It's like when you go to Six Flags or whatever, and then you get walking out to your car. Yeah, yeah. And as we're leaving, this was like a movie-like scene. As we're leaving, we're seeing all these people all dressed and everything, and there's more people, and then it's Murphy's Law. The sexier, raunchier chicks are now showing up, and you're just kind of like, all right, I'm kind of done. But it closes at 7, and it was close to 7.
Yeah, it was.
So it was kind of like, what was it? But it was really kind of still exciting, and as we're getting ready to leave the door, Paul Williams and John Glover were walking right past us to go to their hotel rooms. And we're like, I'm like waving, and Paul like waves it to me. And then John's like, hey. And I was just like, oh my God, this is so great.
That's hilarious.
I'm like, babe, babe. And I'm like holding all these boxes at the same time. They waved at me, man. So now we got to cross the street. Boring. And this is where the crosswalk was very much appreciated. Don't stop there, kiss it naive, mama, don't buy it naive, mama,
got it close, I'm ready to your good night, open your eyes, Lex.
I can't.
Luthers are not afraid. We don't have that luxury. We're leaders. You have a destiny, Lex.
So we get back to the casa. The hotel, and we're all exhausted, but we want to get something to eat. Mm-hmm. So now we're looking for something to eat, places to go. And I'm looking all over. There's no mini fridge in the hotel.
So now we get no pool, no intercontinental breakfast, and no mini fridge.
That's weird.
There was no iron, just an ironing board.
Huh.
There was no safe that to host it in.
Y'all ain't never got two things that match. Neither y'all got Kool-Aid, no sugar. Peanut butter, no jelly. Ham, no burger. Ham.
You go in the bathroom, and you can't turn the water on and then pull up the knob for it to hit out of the...
You gotta put a quarter in?
No, yeah. It would flood. It would. The drain sucked.
Yeah.
So you could only do the... just have it constantly on the overhead shower thing.
Well, Indianapolis is gonna have to do better.
Well, there's more to this story.
Mm-hmm.
So we were like, dude, it's still nice outside. It's like 7 o'clock, and let's go to dinner.
And then here's the thing I liked about Indianapolis. No offense, St. Louis is my home, but 7 o'clock, we're walking the streets.
We're walking here.
This is the difference. 7 o'clock in St. Louis, everybody's rushing to get home before nightfall.
Okay, folks, it's time to get home.
Don't go.
Charles! Sasha, help!
They won't come.
Like Gotham. In Indianapolis, the streets were busting. It was clean.
Mm-hmm.
I was thinking, oh my gosh, this is probably the cleanest city I've ever been in.
So we get up to the room.
And I never want to walk again for the rest of my entire life.
Anymore. My feet were killing me. My shins were starting to hurt.
And I like the fact that we were sitting there just like, oh, what does sound good, man?
Oh my God. This is where it gets better. Let me pull this up. I forgot all about the creepy fucking, I'm dropping everything. But yeah. There we go. A little laughter on that one since Aaron's taking a piss.
No, I'm back.
Wait, wrong one. There. No, that's gross. Here we go. Good pee, sir.
Thank you.
Good hustle.
So,
So we're looking for something to eat, right? And we're like, go to the map. This comes up.
Dick's Last Resort.
Social Cantina. What the? So, they have a lot of cool named places to eat there. Mm-hmm. So we went to this place. I forgot what it was. It was like Lambert the Pub.
Yeah.
And it was right around the corner from the hotel. And it's a firefighter's pub. Dude, it was cool.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have any good pictures, but I will show you the picture I do have right now because it was very... I do have the name of it. Give me a sec. Here we go. But it's like your normal like beer pub. You know, you have the nice beer, you have basic stuff, but the food was good.
Those presidents on the wall?
Yeah,
the
it's like...
politicians
yeah,
on the wall
we're watching the baseball game. It's called the Pub and Eatery. There you go.
We were watching the soccer. St. Louis, Dallas game in soccer.
Yeah, on my phone.
Yes.
So. Big into the foosball while we're eating dinner and watching the baseball game above us. And over the bar, they have this huge fire hose that's signed by all the firefighters who've done major events all over the area.
Which I think is cool.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, nice salute to the first responders out there. And that was good. We had the fish and the all fish. This other stuff.
I thought the fish was amazing. And their chili was really good.
Yeah, we had to took them back. And it was funny. We get the salad and this big-ass thing of chili to bring back. And we forgot we don't have a fucking refrigerator.
Red alert, red alert, red alert.
So that was good. And then the next morning, we wanted to spend the day in Indianapolis.
Wait. No. We got to save that for the next episode.
Thank you, everybody, for listening. Please check out the show notes. Just look into there to get our Discord. And then check out hashtag general where you see all the pictures, videos, all that good stuff. And please check us out next time we come back with Kira
and Polly's Adventures.